How's it going? Scott Devaney again from scottsbasslessons.com. If you haven't checked out scottsbasslessons.com yet, do so after this lesson, because there is zillions, well maybe not zillions, but a lot of video lessons on there, all in HD, and they're all free, ranging from beginner stuff right up to make your brain and explode and tie it in knots kind of stuff. So check that out, it's all for free, and if you subscribe to that website as well, I'll send you a load of free goodies. Today, I'm going to be talking about a dampening technique that I use when playing in a lot of different styles, and a lot of different other pro bass players as well that I've seen and checked out, they use it as well. I haven't seen any lessons done on it really, so I thought I'd put one out there into the onto the interweb. So, the technique is replicating a kind of 60s old school vibe that guys like James Jamerson and Carole Kay used to have. And they had this sound because they used to put foam underneath the bridge of their bass. I'm not sure whether you've seen this before, but if you check out a lot of the old school bass players, they used to have foam underneath the bridge, or some of them used to tape foam across the top of the bridge as well. And it gives a kind of old school vibe to your sound, but nowadays it's tough because on certain tracks when you're playing live, people want that bright, you know, modern tone, and then suddenly that old school vibe would really fit in, but you haven't got time to take your bass off and pick up the other bass with the sponging, and that would mean having multiple basses on stage and all that, you know. So a lot of people use this technique, and it's a palm dampening technique. And you're dampening with this part of the palm. You know, a lot of guitar players use this technique as well, but for different reasons. So you're dampening with this part of the palm, and you're kind of placing it on the strings just past the bridge, kind of the first inch and a half. If you go too far, it'll do this. Look, this is just right. That's just right. This is too much. Hear it? So if I move it back, that's just perfect. So let's take a chord sequence, for instance, C major 7 for one bar, A dominant 7 for one bar, D minor 7 for one bar, and then G7 for one bar. What we're going to do, we're going to play around this bass line, and first of all I'm going to play completely undampened, so I'm just going to use my fingers as normal. This kind of thing. And then after, I'll go twice around the sequence like that, then I'm going to start muting with this part of the palm, and you'll hear what kind of vibe I get from it. And then I'm going to take you through some exercises to show you how you can work this into your own playing. So let's take a look at the chord sequence. 1, 2, 3, 4. So this is no dampening. Dampening. Hear that old school vibe. So, what are the kind of exercises you can do to get this into your playing? Well, the first thing is just to take something with this hand that you really know, you don't have to think about it too much, something like a major scale. So let's take the C major scale. And the first thing to do is just get used to using your thumb and getting the correct amount of damping on the bridge. So I'm going to search around for that correct amount of damping there. I think we've got it there. Now I'm just going to play the major scale at a steady tempo up to from the C to the C. So once more, a little bit faster. Once more again, just a little bit faster. So I can get that comfortable, that speed. And make sure when you play down and you're hitting the thinner strings, it's still dampened, because people have a tendency to dampen the first two strings, the E and the A, but the two thinner strings, they kind of end up ringing out like this kind of thing. You'll get great dampening, and then it'll, you know, go back to being dampened. So make sure you've got that vibe all across the strings. If you can hear some weird noise in the background, by the way, it's my dog snoring down there. So yeah, apologies for that. I didn't wake her up. She's really snoring now. Now, obviously, if you were to just play with your thumb, when it comes to runs and more, you know, ornamentations in your lines, you're going to be quite restricted by just using your thumb. So what I tend to use is my index finger as well, a bit of a mix of the both of them. So to start this off, what I really like to get my students doing is just playing thumb, index, thumb, index, thumb, index. Just the same major scale again, C major scale, just across the strings. So really slowly, I'm going to play thumb, index, thumb, index, thumb, index, thumb, index. And making sure that every note is muted or dampened with this hand. Again. Again, a little bit faster. Again. You can get some nice lines out of that. And if you were playing the same chord sequence, for instance, I'm having to use that finger to bring out, you know, the runs, because it's just too much to do with your thumb. Also, this finger is really cool for bringing out little pops and accents, and you can hear me. Like really pulling it out there, and I kind of use little slaps again against the strings while I'm playing. that isn't, you know, the old school sound, but it's just, I like that kind of percussive style of playing. So I like to get it in my lines as well. But I don't use it all the time. It really depends on the song that you're playing and what's called for within that tune. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to play over the track that we were playing over before, which you can get your free download. Just go to the go to Scott's Bass Lessons and you'll be able to download this track for free, the backing track. I'm going to play over it, but now I'm going to do a close-up of this hand so you can see exactly what's going on. Now, before I go, I just want to say thanks for watching this lesson. And if you haven't been to Scott's Bass Lessons, get on there, check it out. Make sure you subscribe so I can send you the free stuff. And until next time, get in the shed. I'll see you later. Thank you.